activities, okay, with a big orchestra, with Pugliese, Troilo, with many of them. And then in the 60s, come with Sagan and Piazzolla and Rovira, all the avant-garde, you know, the strange things in tango. But those are like the years. Let's start with
just to follow on this question, there was not a question really, but I was following a tango DJ discussion online the other day, and someone wanted to find out which tangos have animal sounds in them. And animal sounds.
Animal sounds?
Yeah. And they came up with an interesting list, like El Amanecer, yeah, with the birds.
Yeah.
And a lot of it's done with the plucking of the
strings. That's right.
And with El Gato, with the meowing, and some with donkeys and cows and things.
That's a very good thing. You know that there's not just one way to answer that, but tango is not just, as I told you, tango is a deep feeling, okay, most of all. But it's not just sadness as many people think it is. In the 20s, in that period, with Julio De Caro, there was a lot of happy, very happy tangos. Many of them was like to have fun in parties or have fun about something particular, okay? And maybe they call gato, not to the animal but to another thing, and they put this animal instead, you know?
Yes.
They start to joke. And because they, just to have fun, many times they put here animal sounds or just to be creative. This director wants to make something different, wants to broke that idea that tango was, even in the 20s, it was something from the old people, you know, their parents and something just to forget their pain. No, it was something happy too. So he started to make many things to renew the tango. Yeah. I think most of all in the 40s was that tangos become slower, most of all were sad. Even more than in the early period. You know that also, as I told you, the tango began with the flute, violin, and guitar, okay? And was quite fast, yeah? But when the bandoneon started to play tango as well, copying what the flute was doing, okay? But they were not really good with the bandoneon. It was a new instrument for them, and they couldn't copy the melody as fast as the flute did. So they copied the melody, but in a slower way, because they couldn't play. It's really fun, but they couldn't play that fast. Yeah. So the tango became a little slower, you know. And the bandoneon has a really characteristic sound, you know, how it is. So like to transmit was like easier to transmit something painful or sadness than something happy. For something happy, we got the flute. Okay. But for the bandoneon, it's like it's like a breath on something that is falling, something huge, okay? Cha-na-na, something big.